I'll try not to be too long. We're going to 1 John chapter number 4. Amen. Good to have my wife with me this morning in Dalton. Amen. My other son. Amen. Glad he's here. Glad God gave me two sons that love church and love God and love the things of God. Amen. Hallelujah. No, no, he's not looking yet. Amen. He ain't looking yet. I don't think he is. Amen. 1 John chapter 4 and verse 15. The Bible said, whosoever shall confess that Jesus is the Son of God, God dwelleth in him and he in God. And we have known and believed the love that God hath to us. God is love, and he that dwelleth in love dwelleth in God, and God in him. Herein is our love made perfect, that we may have boldness in the day of judgment. Because as he is, so are we in this world. Verse 18, if I can get you, draw your attention there. There is no fear in love. But perfect love casteth out fear. Because fear hath torment. He that feareth is not made perfect in love. Don't you hear what he's saying here today? He that hath fear, that feareth, is not made perfect in love. We love him because he first loved us. Amen. Pastor Morrell, would you lead us in prayer here this morning? Heavenly Father, with you. God, I can't do anything without you. Bring your heart to God. Bring your anointing upon him today, God. Your anointing upon the ears of every ear of here today, God.
In Jesus' name.
Oh, God. Lord, help us today, God. We are giving you, Lord, in direction from you, God. In our lives. Hallelujah. God, just follow after.
Thank you, God. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, everyone said amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. I do have a few CDs with me. I was going to say I forgot the display. We left him. We had so much to bring, and I guess I forgot that. But if anyone's interested, we do have some of those with me. Amen. Well, you're happy to be in the house of the Lord today.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Amen. The Bible tells us in these verses of Scripture, again, there is no fear in love, but perfect love casteth out fear.
That's right.
I want to talk today about perfect love.
Right.
Or no fear.
Yeah.
We have a lot of fear in the world today.
That's right.
A lot of anxiety,
that's
unrest.
Right. Come on.
And if I was trying to live my life without God,
yeah.
I understand that.
All right.
Without God, I'd have a lot of fear today.
Yeah. Come on now.
Amen.
Come on now.
And our world today tries to drown it all out with different things.
Right.
They keep themselves so busy. They just don't want to think about their soul. They don't want to think about what's coming.
That's right.
But today I just want to begin with just reminding us of God's love for us.
Uh-huh.
Amen. It is a love that is unexplainable. God's love for man is really, you can't explain it. God can't, you can't explain God. He has to be revealed.
That's right.
Amen. God can't be explained, but it has to be revealed.
Yeah.
And that's the reason why we, in an apostolic church, we
all
get
right.
excited about revelation.
Yeah.
Amen. We get happy about revelation of who this mighty God is.
That's right.
Amen. And because it's just something you got to experience for yourself.
Right.
It's something you got to get. Amen. For yourself.
Yeah.
And you can't
Amen. It can't be explained, but it has to be revealed. And it was revealed to hungry people. Amen. God is not hiding himself from anyone. Oh, hallelujah. You understand, when God made man, when God made man, he could have put it in our DNA that we had no choice but to serve him and love him and worship him. But God made man with a mind to choose for themselves. Amen. You're here this morning by choice. You're in this house today by choice. Oh, hallelujah to God. God didn't get you out of bed and dress you and get you here. But you came on purpose. Oh, hallelujah. I feel the Holy Ghost right now. Amen. And you're going to be, I tell my church all the time, if you're going to be saved, you're going to be saved on purpose. Amen. You're not going to get to heaven and say, man, I can't believe I did this. You go to heaven, he's coming after a bride that have made herself ready. He's coming after a people that have made themselves ready. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. You're not just going to coast into heaven. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We're going to get there. We're going on purpose. Oh, hallelujah. So, but God give man the ability to choose.
Yes, sir.
And we know that Adam and Eve made a bad choice.
That's right.
All of the sin and all of the mess in our world today is a result not of God.
Yes. That's right.
God didn't create it.
That's right.
But sin has caused what is going on, the pain and the hurt in our world today. Amen. But God loved man so much.
Yeah. Come on now.
He said, I'm not going to leave them without some help.
That's right.
That's Amen. You understand the reason we get excited about Revelation.
Yeah. Come on.
It's because we understand that God didn't send his little boy down to die. But God came down himself.
Yes,
God wrapped himself in flesh. God wrapped himself in flesh by the man Christ Jesus and came and died for us. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, I'm going to tell you what, if that don't make you shout, I don't know what can. It don't get no better than that. Amen. God loved you enough, and he loved me enough to say, I'm going to go. Amen. When he looked at Adam in the card and he asked the question, Adam, where art thou?
Yeah. Yeah.
God knew where Adam was hiding.
Right.
He was God.
Yeah.
But what God was saying was, Adam, why did you do this?
Yeah. All right.
Adam, why would you mess this up?
That's right. Come on now.
Amen. But God decided in Genesis chapter 3. Amen. The prophecy began.
Yeah. Come on now.
Oh, hallelujah. He told that serpent, that same woman that you to bruise her heel.
Yeah.
Amen. Is going to bruise your head.
Yeah.
Amen. God already, he was the lamb that was slain from the foundation of the world. And he knew from the beginning what he would do. He didn't have to get with the angels and have a conference about what we're going to do.
Yeah.
God already understood his love for man.
Come on.
And I tell you this morning, God, this afternoon, wherever we're at, it may be afternoon now.
All right.
But God, whole purpose, he wants to commune with man and he wants fellowship with man. But you got to come to him on his terms.
That's right.
Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. His long-suffering, his love for us is amazing.
Yeah, come on now.
How many times have you come to the house of God?
All right.
Feeling like a failure. Feeling like you have failed God. But his love in that service, God just gives you another service, another message that reaches out and gets a hold of you. And God's saying, come on, I got you.
Yeah.
Amen. Just let me say, his love for you is not on its own going to save you. You've got to respond to that love. Amen. Just because he reached for you, just because he's reaching for you, that's just because he's a good God. That's just because he's a loving God. That's just because he's a long-suffering God. Oh, hallelujah. I tell you, God's got a whole lot more long-suffering than we do. But God loved us. Amen. That while we were yet sinners, Christ died. Hallelujah. John chapter 15 and 13. Greater love hath no man than this. That a man laid down his life for his friends.
That's right.
Amen. That's what God did for us. When he didn't even, amen, when we didn't know him.
Yeah. Come on.
He took a chance on us today.
That's right. That's right.
Hallelujah. Romans 5 and 8. God commanded his love toward us. That while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Come on,
oh, hallelujah. I'm going to tell you what. No wonder in our apostolic church.
All right, come on.
We've been born again of water and spirit.
Yeah, yeah.
And we understand that God of heaven came down and purchased us with a great price.
That's right.
While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Yeah, yeah.
God loved us. And brought us to this house today. He could see clear out to 2018. He could see you sitting here today. He could see me here today. Amen. God's love was reaching. Oh, somebody say praise the Lord. Amen. He's in this house today. Oh, hallelujah. I said he's in this house today. Oh, hallelujah. 1 John 3 and 1, what manner of love the Father hath bestowed upon us. That we should be called the sons of God.
All right.
Therefore the world knoweth us not, because it knew him not.
Yeah.
Now God, in his love,
all right. Come on.
He said, I'm not just going to make a way, but I'm gonna make them a part of me.
Yeah, come on now. That's it.
I've heard of unplanned pregnancy.
All right.
But you don't hear too many unplanned adoption.
That's right.
But God,
yes.
Plan.
Yes.
And adoption.
That's right.
Oh, hallelujah. His love for us.
Yes.
He said, I'm going to make them my son.
That's right.
And my daughter.
Yes.
We took on his name in the watery grave of baptism.
Yes, come on, yes.
We took on the name of Jesus Christ.
Right.
And God said, I'm going to make them my son.
Yeah,
I'm going to make them my children.
Yeah.
You understand, we're a part of an inheritance.
Yeah.
And our Father owns everything.
Yeah.
Our Father has it all. But most importantly, he's got eternal life that he's going to give us. We're a part of his inheritance this morning. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. He planned on it.
All right.
I said he planned on it. Going to have an adoption.
All right.
Woo, hallelujah. Thank God for this one to receive the Holy Ghost this morning.
Yeah, hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. God's still adding to the family.
Yes, he is.
God's still bringing them into the family. And God said, there's still another place at the table.
Yeah.
You don't have the Holy Ghost today.
Yeah.
You've not been baptized in Jesus' name. God still has another place at the table. He's got the adoption papers rolled out. Hey, I said he's got the adoption papers rolled out. And he's another place at the table. It's for whomsoever will.
That's right.
God's love.
That's right.
God's mercy.
Yeah.
Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Somebody wave your hand. Woo, hallelujah. Oh, Lord, have mercy. Romans chapter 8 and verse number 15. Hallelujah. Amen, for we have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but we have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. Amen. I'm going to move on here in a minute. But this adoption, the Bible said it's an inheritance that's incorruptible, and it faded not away, and it's reserved for you. It's incorruptible, undefiled, and it faded not away. Let me tell you, this inheritance that God has, you don't have to worry about some crooked attorney getting your inheritance.
That's right.
You don't have to worry about some family member jumping in.
All right, come on.
Oh, help me, Jesus.
Yeah,
we don't have to worry about probate court.
All right.
It's an inheritance.
Yes.
It's undefiled.
Yes.
It's reserved. It's incorruptible. Undefiled. It's reserved. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let me tell you, what God says is yours is yours. Amen. What God has for me, I can take it to the bank. God has it for me. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Are you glad to be a part of the family? I said, are you glad to be a part of the family of God? It's been called out. Amen. It's been purchased with a great price. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yes,
God's looking for a relationship today.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Now, I'm getting where I want to go here in a minute.
All right.
Amen. Well, the Bible said that Christ in Ephesians 3 and 17 may dwell in your hearts by faith, that ye, being rooted and grounded in love, may be able to comprehend with all saints what is the breadth, length, depth, height, and to know the love of Christ, which passeth knowledge, that you might be filled with all the fullness of God. Amen. That revelation again that comes. We get that understanding. A revelation that passes knowledge. Amen. We being rooted and grounded in love. Oh, hallelujah.
All right, preach. Yes, sir.
Had Bible study with a couple ladies here a few weeks ago. Baptized the one, seen her get the Holy Ghost. And this past Sunday night, the other one was baptized. God filled her with the Holy Ghost.
All right.
I'm teaching Bible class. Sometimes on Wednesdays I teach. Sometimes I preach. I was in teaching mode Wednesday. Amen. And I look back there at that wholehearted girl that she said, I never cry. I can't. She had a rough life, tears running down her face.
Right.
Not tears of sorrow, but tears of joy.
All
you know what was happening? Revelation was coming in.
Right.
Revelation, her family had forsaken her because of drugs and because of her lying and cheating to get those drugs. Amen. And tears of revelation and understanding begin to come down her face when she realized that the God of heaven loved her enough to put her in the church. Place her in an apostolic church and give her more than she ever dreamed she could have. Amen. I want this church to understand something this morning. Amen. Don't ever lose the joy of your salvation. Amen. That first experience ought to stay with you. Amen. That experience you got when God filled you with the Holy Ghost. Amen. It still should be alive and well in your heart this morning. Still should be fresh. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. That same God that filled you, same God got to keep you.
Yeah.
Amen. We're saved by the washing of regeneration.
Yeah, all right.
And renewing
yeah.
the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Book of Titus, I believe 3 and 5.
All right.
Renewing
all right.
of the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
That means make new.
That's right. That's
I spoke
right.
in tongues, Brother Rael, when I got the Holy Ghost.
All right.
If I'm going to keep the Holy Ghost, I got to speak in tongues once in a while
all
as
right.
the Spirit gives utterance.
Right.
Get lost in the Holy Ghost.
Right.
Amen. Why? Because I want to be saved.
Yes. Come on. Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen. Now,
preach.
This love for that God has for us, I believe we should understand that.
Yes, sir.
But John says there's no fear in love.
Uh-huh.
Perfect love cast out fear.
Yes.
Because fear hath torment.
All right.
He that feareth is not made perfect in love.
Uh-huh.
We love him because he first loved.
That's right.
Now what God desires.
Yes.
God desires to be desired. There's nothing any more beautiful than walking into an apostolic church.
That's right.
And see the people of God praising God.
That's right. That's right.
Because
yes.
God's looking down.
Yeah.
Amen. The Bible says, let everything have breath praise him.
All right.
Anybody can praise God.
That's right. That's right.
But in St. John chapter 4, he told the woman at the well, that the true praisers
uh-huh.
will worship him.
Yes.
The time is coming and now his true worshipers
yeah.
will worship him in spirit.
Yeah. All right.
Now the only way I read in my Bible that you get the spirit is like they did on the day of Pentecost.
That's right. That's right. Come on.
Jesus said in John 14,
right.
it's coming.
Yeah, that's it. Coming.
It's expedient that I go away or you can't get it. Hallelujah. That's comforter. He said is the Holy Ghost.
Yeah, yeah.
It'll lead you and it'll guide you into all truth.
That's right.
Yeah. Amen. He said if you they're mourning because Jesus said I'm gone. But Jesus said you just need it's better for you that I go because I'm not going to be with you. I'm going to get in you.
That's right.
That same Holy Ghost can be in you today if you don't have it. And if you got it and you haven't renewed it in a while, I pray before you leave here today, you renew that Holy Ghost in your heart one more time.
Yes. Hallelujah.
God's looking for relationship.
Yes, sir. Come on.
Amen. So how do we make,
come on.
How do we make that love perfect?
All right.
A one-sided relationship doesn't work. You can love somebody as much as you can love them, but if they can't love you back, you can only go so far.
That's right. That's
oh, some of you know what I'm talking about.
Yes.
You can give and give and do and
yeah.
do.
Yeah.
Amen. And God's looking down and he's loving.
Yeah.
And he's loving.
Right. Yeah.
And he's giving.
Yeah.
Hey, it's the goodness of God
yeah.
that bringeth men to repentance.
Right.
The goodness of God brought you to this place. The goodness of God brought you to repentance.
That's right.
His goodness, it just keeps coming.
Yeah.
Amen. But after a while,
yeah.
the only way this thing will work is when we start responding.
Yeah.
Amen. When we start responding
yeah.
to the goodness of God and to the love of God.
Come on.
Yeah. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, yeah. hallelujah.
Right.
Amen. Let me tell you, God still desires to be desired. God still wants a people, amen, that knows how to have communion with
him. Come on now. Yes, yes.
Amen.
All right.
I told Drew and Megan in our little session
all right.
that we had a few weeks ago when she was up. I said, you all have been on the phone for a year and a half.
Yeah.
Burning up.
Yeah.
I said, let me tell you something. 90% of marriages fail. Marriage counselors will tell you. Bottom line is, folks, quit talking to one another.
Yeah. Yeah. Come on now.
And I told them, don't ever forget
yeah.
what attracted you to one another in
that's
the first
right.
place.
That's right. Come on.
Put your phones down.
That's
Shut them off.
Yeah.
At some point in your day, every day.
All right.
And just talk.
Yeah. Come on.
Just talk.
All right.
And be reminded of why you like one another in the first place.
Yeah.
Be reminded of what attracted you in the first place. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let me tell you what, these relationships down here. Oh, God, help me, Jesus. I didn't come to a marriage counseling class. But let me tell you something. Oh, hallelujah. Let me tell you, Jesus, or the Bible in Ephesians chapter 5, he compared the church to the bride. And it's a perfect example of how a husband should treat a wife.
That's right.
Husbands, love your wife as Christ loved the church.
Yes.
Ooh.
Come on now.
That's a whole lot of loving, huh?
Yeah. All right.
Amen.
Yeah.
God never one time called his church his old lady.
All right.
He's never one time ignored our phone call. Oh, hallelujah.
Yeah.
Let me just tell you, God, this thing works.
Yeah.
Amen. When we begin to love him back.
All right.
Hey, perfect love cast out fear.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because our Father can do anything.
That's right. That's right.
Our Father is awesome.
Yeah.
But I grew up, my dad started a church. I was 6 years old, 1973. And we were home mission. We didn't have no support.
All right.
It was a work of faith, brother.
Yeah, yeah.
Hallelujah. I lived that. I grew up doing that. Amen. At 6 years old, and so I've been in that church. We're going on 45 years. And I've been there from day one. But I remember growing up, a man let us live in a big 17-room house.
All right.
And rent-free.
All right.
It was, we called it a lean-to. Man, we made good memories in that big old house.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. But I can remember, had the big old long windows, and they weren't insulated windows. We sleep upstairs, and the wind would blow, them windows would rattle.
All right.
And then, you know them old houses, the wind gets blown real hard, and the wind whistles.
Yeah.
It sounds like a haunted house.
Yeah.
Had a tin roof, no insulation. Bird land on that roof, it sounded like Godzilla had landed.
Yeah.
Bird walk across that roof.
Yeah.
I'm laying there in bed.
Yeah.
6 years old.
Yeah.
It sounded like footsteps coming through the house.
All right.
Let me tell you, if you're one of those that has to check out every sound, if you hear something at night and you got to check it out before you can sleep,
yeah,
you would have had to hire security sleeping that house.
Yeah.
I can remember, we guys got used to it, you know.
Yeah.
But let me tell you, if Dad was gone, it was uneasy.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
He preached out a lot. But when Dad was home,
uh-huh,
when I knew Dad was just a room or two away,
right,
I could just close my eyes and go to sleep and not worry about anything because Dad was home.
Yeah. Yeah.
And let me tell you,
yeah,
God is just that way. How many times have you come to church?
Yeah.
Stress.
Come on.
Anxiety.
Yeah.
And you come and get in the presence of the Lord.
All right.
And you get in the presence of God.
Yeah.
And on the outside, nothing changes.
Yeah. Yeah.
But something gets changed in here.
Hallelujah.
And you feel like I can do anything because I got God's with me.
Yeah.
My Father's got this. My Father has his hand on me. And my Father is watching over me. Amen. I just come to tell somebody in this house this morning, you need to quit wringing your hands. And you just need to get close to your Father again. You just need to have a conversation with your Father one more time, whose name is Jesus. Hey, there's nothing he can do. There's nothing he don't have in his hand. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. What God wants in his house today, he wants some people to respond to him. his love. He wants some people to respond to him. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Look at your neighbor and say, my father's got this. Woo, hallelujah. Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
First of all of the commandments,
yeah.
Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart,
yeah.
With all thy soul,
yeah.
And with all thy mind.
Yes, sir. Hallelujah.
Amen. I've seen people. Amen. I've seen some of the poorest people in our church. Amen. Was the most. Amen. Less stressed. Amen. Because they had a walk with God. They understood money. Amen. Finances wasn't going to solve everything. Amen. If you don't have peace with God, you don't know what peace is. Peace doesn't come with financial security. Peace doesn't come. Amen. When the family's all just right. But peace comes when you got peace with your maker and everything he created you. He made you. I said he put his hand on you and he put you in the church. Amen. I said peace really comes when you're at peace with God. Oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Amen. I don't care how long you live for God.
All right.
Life happens.
Yeah.
Life comes.
Yeah.
And life's not fair.
That's right.
But God's fair.
Yeah. That's it. That's it.
Amen.
Come on.
It ain't about here.
All right.
It's about making it.
That's right.
This is just a vapor.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
I don't care what you're going through. If you go through it with him. If you go through it with him,
that's right.
It'll be all right.
That's it.
Oh, hallelujah. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Love the Lord thy God with all thy heart.
Yes.
All thy soul.
Yes.
With all thy mind. Amen. I deal with a pastor. I know I'm sure Pastor Morrell has too. You meet these people, they're angry with God.
Yeah.
Because everything that life has given them.
Yeah.
You know what? You're one of those here this morning.
Yeah.
Don't be angry at God.
That's right.
He's here to help.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
God is here to take care. I can't explain why bad things happen to good people.
Right.
But I know what good people do when bad things happen.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
I know what good people do.
All right. Come on now.
They just come on back,
yeah.
And get in the presence of the Father,
yeah.
And say, Father, you got to walk with me through this.
Oh, yeah.
I don't want to spend the night without you.
Oh,
I want to be by your side.
Yeah.
I need your hand to guide me. Amen. We don't know what we're going to deal with before we get out of here. But I know with God I can face anything. What's perfect love? He's loving you.
Yeah.
You're loving him back.
Yeah.
Amen. There's no fear.
That's right.
Because God.
Come on now.
Amen.
Yeah.
There's no fear.
Uh-huh.
In love.
That's right.
Oh, God.
Come on now.
Help me, Holy Ghost.
Come on.
Several months ago, it's been last year about this time,
right.
We signed on property. Brother Morrell, they accepted our offer, and it was an amazing offer.
Right.
And I felt God was in it.
Yeah.
But the week I signed the note, brother,
yeah.
I had to practice what I preached.
All right.
3:00 in the morning, I'm wide awake. Fear, stress.
Yeah.
My God, what in the world have you done to yourself?
Yeah.
5 acres, 5 buildings. What am I going to do with all that?
Yeah.
And you know what? I felt like what was going on was an attack from hell.
That's right.
I felt like it was. Right. And I remember being at the church on that Friday. And I said, God, if, matter of fact, I hadn't signed yet on the note. I said, God, we still have time to get out. This ain't you.
Yeah.
This is me.
Yeah.
Man, I ain't no way I won't do this without him.
Right.
And so I said, God, you're big enough. If this is, I don't want it if you don't want it.
Uh-huh.
But if this is an attack from hell,
all right,
I want you to send a preacher. Let him call me. Come by.
All right.
Give me an answer. And on a Saturday afternoon, Matthew Watson called me, an evangelist, said, hey, we've been on the coast. We've come in for a few days for vacation, see our folks. So I wanted to bring my brother and sister-in-law up to church tomorrow night on a Sunday. And I said, Brother Watson, please, preach for us. I want you to preach. I want you to.
All right.
He was on his vacation.
All right.
And I'm going to tell you, church, Brother Watson got in that pulpit, and he wasn't in there 5 minutes, and he turned around.
All right.
And he said, church, your pastor has been under an attack from hell this
All right.
week.
All right.
And I come to expose the devil for what he's doing.
All right.
Amen. God told me to tell you he's in this.
All right.
Everything's going to be all right.
All right.
Have I got enough money to finish it? No, but I got enough to keep working.
That's
Hallelujah. And I'm not worried about it because God's got it in his hand. And I'm watching God do miracles. I'm watching God do things. Amen. Let me tell you something. I praise you. You need to understand. God, you want this thing to get real. You want this thing to get real. It's time to love him with all your heart, your soul, your mind, and strength. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. We are in a day where, amen, the Bible said in the last day, Jesus said, men will be lovers of pleasure more than lovers of God. It's coming into the church. Let me tell you, there's nothing, amen, there's nothing any more important than being in the house of God and loving God and worshiping God. In your week, this is the most important time of your week and of your day. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let me tell you, you can tell God you love him all you want. Amen, but it's shown in action. It's shown by what you do. It's shown by what you're not doing. Amen. I can tell my wife all day long I love her. But if I'm not showing her, amen, and I'm not treating her the way she needs to be treated, amen, it's just words. I'm telling you, God is reaching for somebody today. And he's saying, it's time that you start loving me back.
Hallelujah.
All this stress and anxiety, you're trying to get it all figured out yourself.
All right.
I said, come get my presence.
Yeah. Yeah.
Come get my presence.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Amen. I got the answer for you.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah. Hey, hallelujah. I don't know what time it is. Don't know what time I started. Amen. Hallelujah. Anxiety is the painful uneasiness of mind that feeds on impending fears.
That's it.
Amen. Every one of us here dealt with it.
That's right.
It's a human part of being human.
Uh-huh.
Amen. But it's what we do with it.
That's right.
Anxiety highlights the human viewpoint.
Yes.
And strangles the divine.
Yes.
So we become fearful.
All right.
When David walked out on that battle, the human mind sees in it a giant and a kid.
Yeah.
But David wasn't being a little smart aleck kid.
That's right. That's right.
David truly seen, he didn't see a giant.
That's right.
He seen a giant cursing his God.
All right. All right.
And David was saying, giant, God, you're nuts, giant.
Yeah. Yeah.
You're crazy, giant.
Yeah.
Amen. That's what happens when we get close to our Father.
All right.
We ain't looking at the giant, but we're looking at the God.
Yeah. All right. Come on.
And we can look at the giant saying, you ain't nothing, giant.
All right. All
you ain't nothing, giant, compared to my God.
Yeah. Come on. Preach.
Hallelujah.
All right.
David had a walk with God.
Yeah. Come on.
So anxiety Amen. But we got to get God back in the picture.
That's right.
I said you got to get God back in the picture.
That's right.
Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. I hope it's all right.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Anxiety chokes our ability to distinguish the incidental from the essential, so we get distracted.
All right. All right.
Oh, hallelujah. Help me, Jesus.
Come on, preach.
There's essentials.
Yes.
And there's things that's not essential.
That's right.
Amen.
Yes.
Anxiety gets your mind on those things you think you gotta have.
Those things
you think you gotta have right now.
That's right.
Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Anxiety siphons our joy, makes us become negative.
Uh-huh.
Oh, hallelujah, yeah. Hallelujah. We worry when we add unnecessary pressure to an already full plate.
All right.
I'm talking about fear.
Yes, sir.
Perfect love casts out fear.
Uh-huh.
Amen. We worry when we subtract God's presence from our crisis. Crises are going to come.
Yes.
Crises are going to happen.
That's right.
But get God in the middle of your crisis.
Yeah. Come on now.
Keep God in the middle of it.
All right. All
hallelujah.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
amen. I can't help it. I got to get back.
Please.
Amen. Giant God.
Yeah.
I got God in the middle of this.
Yeah.
I got God in the middle of this. I don't know what's going to happen, but I know my God. I know who my Father is, and He's got His hand on this. And I'm not going to worry about this giant. I'm a child of the King. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. We worry when we forget God's presence and God's sovereignty. We worry when we subtract His timing from our plan. When we eliminate prayer from daily routine.
All right.
When we subtract divine perspective from tough times.
All right.
Anxiety overcomes us when we subtract God's infinite power for our own feeble initiative.
Yeah. All right.
Amen. You're a child of the King.
That's it. Come on.
You're a child of the King.
All right.
All right. Amen. My son just got married. He's taking on some responsibility.
Yeah.
It's time for me to back out and say, help, Lord.
Yeah.
You know, let me tell you.
Yeah.
You need to understand.
All right.
You've been kicked out of the family.
Come on.
In God's family. You haven't grown up.
All right.
And don't need your father.
That's right.
Oh, y'all ain't hear me
come
right
on now.
What's beautiful about living for God?
Yeah.
It's when you can understand. It doesn't matter how old you get, how long you live for God.
I still
need my father.
That's right. That's right. Come on.
Hallelujah. Amen. And when you can understand. I'm not in this by myself. I'm not walking this alone. But I got a heavenly Father that's in the middle of this with me.
Come on. Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Your heavenly Father, He's open for business every day of the week. Anytime you need to see Him.
That's right. Come on.
And He has whatever you need. Hallelujah. I was responsible for my son while he lived home. To make sure he was clothed, fed,
right.
cared for.
Yeah.
Now he's out of the house.
All
right. Let me tell you something.
Yeah.
We're not out of God's house.
That's right.
God took that responsibility.
That's right.
God took that responsibility. Oh, y'all hear me right now.
Yeah.
God took that responsibility.
Yeah. Come on now.
And He said, you're my child.
Yeah.
I'm going to take it all. We've been adopted.
Yeah. All right.
Oh, hallelujah. Amen. I don't know if there's adopted parents in here today, but I'm going to tell you what. You went to adopted parents, and they go down to that adoption agency. They didn't say, well, we have one here, but you didn't go down there and say, well, can they clean the house?
No.
How much money do they have?
Uh-huh.
What are they able to do or not? No.
Yeah.
Amen. You took them in. Amen. And you became their parents. And that's what God's done for us. He's still responsible. Amen. When you do what he, amen, you live for him and you do what God wants you to do. He still got this. He still got you in his hand. Oh, hallelujah. Lift your hands and love the Lord right now. Praise God. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Don't subtract divine perspective. Amen. From tough times. Hallelujah. All things work together.
That's right. That's right.
The good of them.
That's right.
Love the Lord. Job said, let me tell you, we can read the book of Job and we can see the conversation that God and the devil had.
That's right.
Let me tell you something. Job didn't know about that conversation.
Come on.
All he knows, when one day's time, his whole world got turned upside down. But he said, the Lord giveth. And the Lord take it away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We worry when we multiply our problem by inserting our solutions prematurely. Amen. We pray in God, we need you to take care of this. But we try to help him out. Amen. Let God do it. Amen. Let God do it. They that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. Amen. We were when we divide life into secular and the sacred. Amen. If you live for God, it all should be sacred. It should all be about God. Oh, hallelujah. It's all about him. Oh, let's stand right now. Musicians, would you come? Hallelujah. 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 Amen. The Bible said, by this we know that we love the children of God when we love God and keep his commandments.
Yes.
Verse 3 said, for this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments.
Keep his commandments.
And his commandments are not grievous.
That's it.
This is the love.
All right.
It's more than saying, God, I love you.
Yes, sir.
There's commandments in this book. Hallelujah. There's some commandments in this book that's going to prove whether you love him or not. Hallelujah. Amen. Who reach out to the Lord right now? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Who reach out to the Lord? Amen. Faith is to God what fear is to the devil. Faith is to God what fear is to the devil. Amen. I believe today God has sent me by here to let somebody know. If you could just get back in your Father's presence. Amen. If you could just get back in your Father's presence. If you don't know God today, amen, there's still room at the table. Amen. There's still room at the table. As for whosoever will. I wonder this morning, I don't know how y'all normally do it, but I wonder if we could gather in this front for just a little while today. Amen. Let's just remain standing. And let's just talk to God for a few moments. Lift our voices to him. Hallelujah. I believe today there's some folks in this house. There's some folks in this house need to get back in God's presence for a little while. Hallelujah. He can let you know once again, I got your hand. I got this covenant. Hallelujah. You're my child and I love you. Amen. You belong
Jesus,
to me.
I love you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Because you care.
Oh, come on. Let's talk to God today.
I couldn't imagine.
Yeah.
If you weren't there, Jesus, I love you.
Come on, church.
Because you care, I couldn't imagine.
Yes, Lord.
If you weren't there, Jesus, I love you.
Come on, let's obey the Holy Ghost.
Because you can.
We reach out, let's pray with somebody right now.
I couldn't imagine.
Oh, let's pray God's strength.
If you
let's create
care.
An atmosphere of God's presence.
Jesus, I love you.
Oh, Jesus, I love you.
Because you care. I love you, I love you.
Jesus, I love you.
Jesus, I love you, I love you. Because you care. Jesus, I love you, I love you. Jesus, I love you, I love you. Jesus, I love you, I love you. Because you care. Jesus, I love you.
With somebody
you're
today. Let's pray with one another.
In my
let's ask God to strengthen.
Your loving arms protect me and they shelter
hallelujah,
me
hallelujah,
from harm.
Hallelujah.
You are somebody my Omega, the beginning and the end. You're my strong tower. You've been my dearest and best friend. And it was you. I love you because you care. I couldn't imagine if you weren't there. Jesus, I love you because you care. I couldn't imagine if you weren't there. Jesus, I love you.
God, I've got to reciprocate that love. God, I've got to give you what you deserve this morning.
Because you can.
Hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Come on, he's worthy of our praise. He's worthy of our honor. He's worthy of our praise this morning.
Jesus, I love you, I love you.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Jesus, I love you, I love you.
Jesus, I love you.
Jesus, I love you.
Come on, it ain't gonna hurt you to say those words right now. It ain't gonna hurt you to say those words right now.
Jesus, I love you, I love you.
Jesus, I love you.
Jesus, I love you, I love you.
Oh, I love you, God.
Jesus, I love you, I love you.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Because you care.
certainly appreciate the man of God coming by this morning and reminding all of us of just how much God loves us and just how much we need to love him in return. Perfect love casteth out fear. We don't have to live with fear. We don't have to live with anxiety. We may have to deal with it, but we don't have to live with it. Hallelujah. There's an answer to our fears. There's an answer to our anxieties, and that's responding to the love of God that he has shown to us this morning. Can we give God, can we give the man of God a great big hand clap? Can we give God a hand clap of praise? Can we be grateful and thankful this morning, hallelujah, for the reminder this morning that we've had of just how much God loves us. Brother Osmond said he had a few CDs. Amen. They're for sale. If you'd like to get a CD, a singing CD that he has, just get with him after church. Make sure, church family, you make this brother know how much you appreciate his preaching to us here today. He has helped us. Hallelujah. He has helped Higher Praise Tabernacle today. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 God bless you today. Shake hands. Show yourself friendly. Go ahead.